अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वेलकम टू एपसेक्स ऑनलाइन सपोर्ट प्रोग्राम। दिस इज क्लास टेंथ वीक 12 लेसन 1 एंड सब्जेक्ट बायोलॉजी। टेक्स्ट बुक बायोलॉजी पेज 144 अप टू 145। यूनिट 17 बायोटेक्नोलॉजी। टॉपिक इज जेनेटिक इंजीनियरिंग। Objectives: By the end of the lesson, you will be able to understand or discuss genetic engineering, objectives of genetic engineering, and basic steps in genetic engineering. Genetic engineering, which is also known as the modern biotechnology, it can be defined as the artificial synthesis, modification, removal, addition, and repair of the genetic material, that is the DNA. It means that the defective part of the DNA can be easily modified or it can easily be repaired. So this technology was developed in midst of 1970s when the scientists were able to confirm of the fact that yes, the DNA can be cut or pasted on some other organisms, which results in the change in the characteristics of the organisms. For the transfer of the DNA, bacteria is used as a host because the multiplication rate of the bacteria is high. So it is possible to obtain million copies of the specific DNA. But apart from the bacteria, viruses can also be used or some other organisms can also be used for this purpose. Objectives of genetic engineering: isolation of the gene or its part for the various purposes such as the gene therapy, the production of the particular RNA and protein molecule. It means that the gene of interest will be isolated, which needs to be multiplied, and this will produce proteins. Improvement in the production of enzyme drugs and commercially important organic chemical means that the enzyme and drugs can also be produced, which are important for the use of the human beings. Desirable characteristics can also be produced in plants, so we can get a different varieties of plants of our own choice. Treatment of the genetic defects: we identify the defective gene and then replace it with a normal gene. So the genetic defects can easily be treated in higher organisms. Now we will discuss the basic steps in genetic engineering, which is the first one is the isolation of the gene of interest. We can isolate the gene of interest from any of the organism. Then insertion of the gene into the vector. Now this gene is inserted into the vector, which is a carrier. The transfer of recombinant DNA into the host organism. By inserting of the gene into the vector then become the vector in this gene of interest become recombinant DNA, which is again transferred into the host organism. Then that host organisms converted into the GMO, that is a genetically modified organism. And then in genetically modified organism, the gene of interest get expressed. Now all these steps will be discussed in detail by the help of the upcoming diagram. So this diagram shows the production of the insulin gene through the genetic engineering. This diagram or this production of the insulin completes in 5 steps. So the first step is the isolation of the gene of interest. So in this step, the genetic engineers identify the gene of interest, which is the insulin gene in this case. The insulin gene will be isolated or cut from the total DNA of the organism. This gene will be cut by the help of endonuclease enzyme, as you see in this example. The endonuclease enzyme is basically a molecular scissor which cut the specific part of the gene of the interest, which is insulin in this case. So the molecular scissor, that is the endonuclease, cut this yellow part of the gene, which is basically the gene of interest, that is the insulin gene. Now we will move towards the second step, that is the insertion of the gene into the vector. Now coming towards this site, this is the host organism, which is bacteria. In this case, we use bacteria because the multiplication rate of the bacteria is high. So it will give us million of copies of the DNA. So the gene has this isolated gene has to be transferred into this host organism. So this gene has to be inserted into the some organism like a vector, which is actually carrier. So the carrier in this case may be the plasmid of the bacteria. In bacteria, we have extracellular DNA, that is known as the plasmid. So the plasmid can act as a vector. Vector mean carrier. So this plasmid or vector can carry this gene of the interest. So we isolate the plasmid from the bacteria for the insertion of this isolated gene. We will first cut the plasmid with endonuclease enzyme. The endonuclease enzyme is also known as the breaking enzyme. Now, with the help of the ligase enzyme, we attach this gene of interest with this plasmid. Now, the gene of interest and this plasmid, this is also a DNA, and this gene of interest is also a part of the DNA. So two different types of DNA get attached. So this is now known as recombinant DNA. Now this is not called, in this case, now this is known as not a gene of interest and this is not a plasmid, but as a whole, this is now known as the recombinant DNA. So, the next step is the recombinant DNA, the vector and the gene of interest together, now known as the recombinant. This is the recombinant DNA. Now, the recombinant DNA will be inserted into the host again, which is bacteria in this case. So, by inserting this recombinant DNA again into this same bacteria, the bacteria now become genetically modified. So this bacteria is now known as the genetically modified organism. If we use viruses, so we can say this now become a genetically modified bacteriophage or modified organism. If bacteria, so we can say that this is a genetically modified bacterium. Now, the fourth step is the growth of this GMO, genetically modified organism or genetically modified bacteria. Now, this bacteria or this GMO will grow. It multiplies and give us a multiple copies of the gene of the interest, which was insulin in this case. And this multiplication happens. The gene of interest will multiply with the division of the plasmid. As the bacteria multiply, the plasmid multiply, and automatically the gene of interest or this DNA will get multiplied. The last one is the expression of the gene, which is the most important step in this regard. Basically, the expression of the gene results in the formation of the protein. Insulin is basically a protein in nature. So, this expression of the gene results in the formation of the protein. If protein is formed, So if the protein is formed, it shows the expression of the insulin gene, but if the desired protein, that is the insulin, is not formed, it means that the gene is not properly attached with the plasmid, or maybe the bacteria die due to some unavailability of the proper food or medium. But if the gene expressed, then million of the copies of DNA will be formed and it will give us insulin. The insulin then be collected in bottles and can be sold out. So this was all about the steps in the